I feel the need.
The need for speed. The 1DX Mark III is a powerful machine packed with some crazy specifications. And this 1DX Mark III right over here was chosen by Canon to perform in the Super Bowl here in Miami. That's right, you're looking at an athlete, and to support such an athlete, it needs a very fast memory card to keep up with it. And that's what the new CFexpress Type B card is all about, speed. But what is it about this card that makes it so special, and how different is it from any other fast memory card? But before I get into it, shout out to Canon for supporting this video. And remember, come visit us here at the Digital Goja showroom in Miami. And don't forget, we publish new content weekly. So subscribe to our channel and tap the bell icon to get notified about our latest videos. It seems like newer, faster card formats are coming out all the time. So why are you gonna want another one? While the new CFexpress cards are probably going to be the new standard going forward, the 1DX Mark III has dual CFexpress card slots. The Nikon Z6, Z7 recently added support for CFexpress cards with a firmware update, and many other cameras might start following in their footsteps. It's also interesting that these cards may start being used in other devices other than cameras, such as the upcoming Xbox Series X console, which may support CFexpress cards for expandable storage memory. The reason why is because the CFexpress card's read and write speed make it possible to go where no card has gone before.
To boldly go where no one has gone before.
Well, at least record what no other card has recorded before. It has theoretical transfer speeds up to, wait for it, 1.97 gigabytes per second, 3 times faster than previous CFast 2 and nearly 12 times faster than compact flash cards used in other cameras, such as the 1DX Mark II. This allows you to record higher resolution, higher bit depth video straight into your camera without the need for an external recorder. If you're looking for a card with the fastest read-write speeds, choose one with the highest capacity, not because of the storage, but the higher you go, the faster the speeds. You'll also be able to reach faster continuous shooting speeds, and it doesn't get as hot as other cards, so you'll be able to shoot longer. Check this out. I doubt that you'll ever reach a point with this camera where it will slow down and start buffering. This is a beast of a camera. It will allow you to shoot 16 frames per second through the viewfinder or 20 frames per second in live view for over 1,000 frames, even when the camera is set to record RAW or RAW plus JPEG. Now, it's always important to stick with recommended brands, as some brands may have compatibility issues with some cameras. And the price, it depends on the storage capacity of the cards, but in some cases, it's actually more affordable than CFast 2 cards. Currently, you can expect to pay about $150 for a 64 gigabyte, up to $600 for a 512 gigabyte CFexpress card. I expect as more cameras start utilizing this standard, the price of the cards may drop. I know these prices sound high, but to put things in perspective, the Red Digital Cinema Minimag 480 gigabyte card, which is what's used in a high-end cinema camera used in Hollywood, tops out at 300 megabytes per second and costs a whopping $1,450. Yikes. So you're getting more bang for your buck than these hotshot filmmakers. Take that, Michael Bay. If you like this video, remember, hit the thumbs up button below, subscribe to our channel and tap the bell icon. And if you're in Miami, come visit us here at the Digital Goja showroom. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.